in your hand.
Hold the power of life.
Hey guys, Justin here, and I'm really excited to introduce you to TESmart's latest 2x1 and 4x1 multimedia KVMs. If you're new to KVMs, it's simply a device that allows you to use multiple computers with one keyboard, one mouse, and your monitor. This avoids having to unplug and replug your devices when you want to use a different computer. TESmart KVMs are unique in that they are compatible with all computers, as well as gaming consoles, streaming devices, and pretty much anything that has an HDMI output, even digital cameras. We have a chart on our website showing the differences between the new and the older models, but the main highlights are faster refresh rate, better mouse and keyboard compatibility, and an upgradable firmware. As with prior models, these KVMs are capable of up to 4K resolution with 60 Hz, but these new A2U models can go a blazing 144 Hz for both 1080p and 1440p. One of the best new features is called pass-through mode. This allows the multimedia and special function keys on your keyboard to work with a KVM. You can play or pause music, turn the volume up or down, and even launch applications. With pass-through mode, most gaming keyboards are compatible, and you can see the growing list of keyboards that we've tested on our website. The KVM works with both wired and wireless keyboards, but Bluetooth is only supported if you use a Bluetooth receiver in the KVM's USB 2.0 port. The TESmart KVMs have the ability to control the input using a hotkey command. This is a shortcut pattern like scroll lock 2 to select PC number 2. For these models, you can assign the hotkey trigger to either scroll lock or right control, which is important for Apple keyboards since they do not have a scroll lock button. Being a multimedia unit, the KVM also works great with gaming consoles. You can use your keyboard and mouse, and you can listen on your monitor, your headphones, or your external speakers. All right, let's quickly go over the device. Looking at the front, we have the on-off switch, an analog audio output, which is actually on the back of the four-port model, LEDs to tell you which connections are active and which is selected, a physical button for switching inputs, the IR receiver for the remote control, and a light that's going to show you if the pass-through mode is activated. Going to the back of the switch now, we have HDMI and USB inputs for your devices, two dedicated ports for mice and keyboards. These ports have specific programming, so only mice and keyboards are going to work in these. Then we have a standard USB 2.0 port, which can be expanded with a powered USB hub. Then we have the HDMI output to the monitor, and finally the 5-volt AC adapter. If you're interested in seeing a full demo and a setup tutorial for this KVM, check out the next two videos in this series. Thanks and have a good day.